Good morning, student. Today we are going to discuss our fifth unit, Children and Women in Sports. Motor development in children. Motor development means development of child bones and muscles which help him to move around and manipulate in the environment. Each and every development in child is a motor development. Motor developments bring perfection in actions and movement. Motor development, it is of two types, gross motor development and fine motor development. Gross motor development means development of large or big muscle in the child body, like development of hand muscles, leg muscles, etc., which help him to do big. These big muscles help him to do big activity like standing, walking, jumping, running, etc. And fine motor development means development of small muscles like muscles of the fingers, etc., which help him to do fine activities like catching, throwing, writing, picking, etc. This is about the motor development. Okay, motor development means development of child bones and muscles which help him to move around and manipulate in the environment. Motor development, it is of two type, gross motor development and fine motor development. Gross motor development means development of big muscles like muscles of the hand, leg, etc., which help him to do big activity like standing, running, jogging, jumping, etc. And fine motor development means development of small muscles like muscles of the finger, etc., which help the child to do fine activity like catching, writing, picking, etc. What are the factors that affect motor development? First is parents and heredity. As a child gets genes from their parents, as heredity does the motor development follow the same patterns as their parents. Nutrition, if the child take proper diet, proper nutrition, then there will be the proper motor development. Immunizations, if the mothers and child both are immunized at proper time, then there will be the good motor development. Environment, if we provide safe, clean and healthy environment, then there will be the good motor development in the child. Psychological feedback and motivation. If we encourage and motivate child to perform physical activity by which it's help in motor development, if the child participate in physical activity, his motor development will be more. Disability and disease. Motor development in disabled and disease affect the motor development. If the person is disabled, if he is affected from any disease, then there will be the less motor development in child. Regular practice. If the child do regular practice, then there will be the perfection in his movement, in his action. Body weight, motor development is also depend upon body weight. The person who is overweight or obese, their motor development is less, whereas the child who is healthy, his motor development will be more, that is perfection in his skill, action, etc. Mental ability also affect motor development, as children have less perfections in their movement as compared to those who are mature. Gender or sex difference also affect motor development between boys and girls. Rest and relaxation. If the child get proper rest, proper relaxations, there will be the proper motor development. Proper training for motor development and skill perfections. Proper coaching and training is required. If we give proper training, proper training, then there will be the proper development. There will be proper motor development. Safety measures. we should consider the safety measures. Safety healthy environment should be provided for proper motor development. Interest and attitude. If the interest and attitude of child is one of the important factors for motor development, we should motivate. If the child is interested in developing his motor development, interest in doing physical activity, then his motor development will be more. Multi-activity. The child who participate in multi-activity, there will be good motor development. These are the some factors that affect motor development. Exercise guideline at different stages of growth and development. What exercise we should do at different stages of growth and development? First, growth and development, these are the two different things. Growth means it is an increase in size. Growth, it is an increase in size of an individual, like increase in height, weight, etc. And it can be measured. Development, growth, it is a quantitative change in the child. Development, it is a qualitative change, change in quality, change in functioning. It cannot be measured, like development of child brain, development of child bones, etc. And what exercise we should do at different stages of growth and development? First stage, babyhood stage. Babyhood, growth and development. Babyhood stage, that is from birth to 1 year. At this stage, gross motor development take place. Okay, motor development start after birth and follow progressive and sequential manners from top to bottom. At babyhood stage, gross motor development take place. That is, the child try to it happened primarily at neck, shoulders, arm. Fine motor development at babyhood stage, fine motor development is missing. He is unable to control his control over his finger, face, etc. And what activity the child should do at this stage? At this stage, the child should do the gross motor development activities like sitting, standing, rolling, walking, etc. And we should provide him safe, clean, healthy environment, proper diet, proper vaccinations, etc. should be done. The parents should take proper care for the proper gross motor development of a child. Next is infancy growth and development. Infancy growth and development, infancy stage, that is from 1 to 2 years. At this stage, gross motor development take place. The child should be provided healthy diet, playful environment, safe and healthy environment, etc. And what activity the child should do at this stage? The child should do the activities like crawling, sitting, walking, rolling, bending, etc. And proper rest and sleep should be provided to the child for proper gross motor development. And the environment should be safe, clean, hygienic, etc. Early childhood stage. Early childhood stage, that is from 2 to 6 years. At this stage, gross motor development and fine motor development take place. The children should provide healthy, playful environment, proper diet, proper environment, etc. should be provided. At this stage, the activities, the child should perform the activities like running, throwing, kicking, ladders climbing, recreational activities like ball catching, fun game, rope jumping, etc. This type of activity, the child should done for proper gross and fine motor development. Later childhood stage, later childhood state, that is from 7 to 12 years. At this stage, both gross motor development and fine motor development take place. At this stage, the child soon perform the activities like yoga, gymnastics, swimming, team game like basketball, volleyball, badminton, etc. These types of activity the child should perform at this stage for proper gross and fine motor development. Adolescence stage, that is from 13 to 19 years. This is the most delicate period and challenging period for the parents due to lack of knowledge to the child. At this stage, sex difference is prominent and brings sex conclusions, that is physical, psychological, mental, etc. change take place. Adolescence age cause many changes like physical, social, psychological, etc. Their attachment towards friend is more as compared to parents, and the child should perform the activities like team game. The child should, at this stage, the child have more energy. Therefore, he should do heavy workout, heavy exercise. Team game. He should take proper diet for proper gross motor, for proper motor development. Heavy workout, creative activities, proper use of finance, controlling their emotions, etc. This type of activity the child should perform at this stage. This is about the motor development. Okay, motor development in children and the exercise guideline at different stages of growth and development. Next is posture. Posture, it is a specific body position. Okay, postures means specific body positions, means balancing the body in accurate and proper manner so as to produce least fatigue. If the person has good postures, then there will be the least fatigue. Posture may be static or dynamic. Static like sitting, standing, lying, and dynamic like walking, running, etc. This is about the posture. Okay, posture means body position, specific body positions, means balancing the body in accurate and proper manners so as to produce least fatigue. Postures, the best posture is that in which the body segments are balanced in the positions of least strain and maximum support. Postures, there are different view about the postures. According to physical educationists, postures, it is a tools of mechanical efficiency of body which cause minimum stress to muscles and maximum output of physical efficiency. According to physical education, if a person has good postures, then there will be the minimum stress to the muscles and maximum output of physical efficiency. And according to the doctors, posture means soundness or physiological balance of the body. And according to actors, posture means it is a tool to express their emotion and attitude. If the actors is able to express their emotions, attitude, it means that he has a good posture. So from this we can conclude that good postures help the body to function efficiently and effectively. If the person has good postures, then his body will function efficiently and effectively. His personality will be improved. The person's posture is good, his personality will also good. He will able to express If the person has good personality, he will be able to express his idea, express his emotions, attitude, etc. And the efficiency of body depend upon good posture. It is directly related to health status of individual. And by doing the good postures, if the person do a good postures, then the body will get proper rest. Our body will not feel fatigue. The persons will remain mentally, physically healthy, and our bones will be in their natural shape and in proper alignment. What is the correct standing postures? Correct standing postures is that correct standing positions. The standing is a position in which the body is held upright positions and supported only by the feet in a correct postures. In a correct postures, the feet should be apart about 4 to 6 inches, that is at shoulder distance. The feet should be parallel to each others, and our body weight should be balanced in both the feet, and one should stand straight and erect. And when we view from side, our ear, shoulders, hip, knee, ankle should be in a straight line. The center of gravity should be within the center of the feet. This is the correct standing postures. And the correct walking posture, what is the correct walking postures? The correct walking postures is that in walking posture, the feet, our feet should be straight and push the ground backward, and then the weight, our body weight, is transferred to the toe, that is heel to toe actions. Walking should look smooth, efficient and graceful. And what is the correct sitting posture? The correct sitting postures is that in correct sitting postures, our backbone should be erect, straight, so that natural curve should be visible. The upper region of the backbone should be straight against the back of the chair. The head should be in a line with the hip and shoulders. The arm should be balanced, and the waist should touch the back of the chair. The thigh should be straight in line, resting on the seat, and the legs should rest vertically on the feet, and we should look front. This is the correct sitting posture. What are the advantages of correct posture? The first advantage of correct posture is that attractive physical appearance. If we have good postures, then our personality will be improved. We will look smart, good looking, charming and attractive. Our personality will be improved if we have good posture. Improve health status. If a person has good postures, then his health status will be good. The persons will look fit and healthy. Psychological balance. If a person has good postures, it means that the person is psychologically fit. It improves the activeness of the mind. The mind will remain active. It helps to lead optimum development of the mind. The person has good postures. Leisure strain and pain over the joint. If the person has good postures, there will be the less strain and pain over the joint, as our weight is equally distributed over the joint. Okay. If we have good postures, our body weight is balanced in both the legs, so there will be the less pain over the joint. Improve social status. If our posture is good, then our social status will be good. We will look happy. Our image of happy lifestyle, social well-being, our social quality will be improved. We will if we have good posture, our source of quality will be improved. Better functioning of body system. If we have good postures, then our body internal organs will function properly. It's help in optimum functioning of our internal organs. Improve appetite. If we have good postures, then there will be the least strain over the abdomen. Our digestive organs functions properly. Therefore, it's help to improve our appetite. Reduce posture deformity. Of course, if we have good postures, then it have to reduce the posture deformity like knock knee, kyphosis, bow leg, flat foot, etc. This type of posture deformity will be reduced if we have good posture. Better skin perfections. If we have good postures, then our skin will be perfect. Better selection of place. The correct postures of place help the coach to help. If a person has good postures, then there will be the perfection in his activity, in his movement. Therefore, it's help to improve, it's help in perfection in skin if the person had good posture. Better selection of place. If the player have good postures, then there will be the perfection in his action, perfection in his movement. Therefore, the coach can easily select a better player with the help of his posture. Optimum physical efficiency. If a player has good postures, then his physical efficiency will be improved. Good body balance. Correct postures provide good balance. There will be the more stability of the individual by performing the workout. These are the some advantages of good postures. If the person has good postures, these are the some advantages. Okay, his personality will be improved, his health status will be improved, the persons will psychologically fit. It's help in proper functioning of his internal organs. It helps in reducing the posture deformity, least pain over the joint, improve his social quality, health status, good balance, good body balance, etc. These are the some advantages of good postures. And what are the cause of bad postures? The cause of bad postures, there are many causes. Some are environmental cause and others may be due to heredity. Heredity is also the cause of postures, and bad postures cause many health problems. Okay, the first cause of bad posture can easily corrected and prevent if early step can be taken. Some of the main cause of bad posture is accident due to sometime if there is any mishappening, if there is any accident, then there will be the chance of posture deformity. Disease. If the person has health problems like illness, chronic sickness, then his posture will be bad. Lack of nutritional diet. If the person does not take proper diet, if he have unbalanced diet, under diet or over diet, or there is a lack of nutritional diet, then also his posture will be bad. Wrong posture habit. If the person has wrong posture habit during standing, walking, lying, etc., then there will be the bad posture. Improper treatment. If there is improper treatment, if there is a wrong treatment of the injury, then there will be the chance of bad posture. Psychological stress. If the person has psychological stress, tensions, if he's not mentally fit, then It leads to posture deformity. Lack of sufficient strength. If the person has less strength, then his posture will be bad. Age factors. Age factors is also the cause of bad postures. As the age increase, then his postures will be bad. Okay. In old age, the muscle strength is reduced. The strength of the muscles reduced, which lead to bad posture. Poor eyesight. If the person's eyesight is weak, then the body bent forward, which leads to bad posture, bad shoes or clothes. And sometimes, if a person's wear the bad quality shoes, tight clothes, it leads to bad posture, posture deformity. These are the some cause of bad postures. Okay, what is postures? What are the cause of bad postures and what are the advantages of good postures? Postures means positions of the body, specific body positions. Okay, postures means specific body positions, means balancing the body in accurate and proper manners so as to produce least fatigue. Posture may be static or dynamic. Static means fixed, like sitting, standing. Dynamic, like running, walking, etc. And there are different view about the postures. According to physical educationists, postures, if the person has good postures, according to physical exercise, posture, it is a tools of mechanical efficiency of the body, which cause minimum stress to muscles and maximum output of physical efficiency. And according to the doctors, posture means soundness of physiological balance of the body. And according to the actors, posture means ability. Posture, it is a tool to express his emotion and attitude. And what are the advantages of good postures? If the person has good postures, then his personality will be good. The person will look attractive. His health status will be improved. The person will be physically, mentally, socially fit and healthy. There will be the least pain over the joint. Proper functioning of the internal organs. Improve appetite. Reduce posture deformity. If the person had good postures, then the chance of posture deformity will be reduced. Posture deformity like knock knee, kyphosis, lordosis, ascoliosis, etc. Better skill perfection. There will be the perfection in his movement, in his skill. The overall efficiency of the body will also improve. And what are the cause of bad postures? The cause of bad postures, it may be due to environmental factors. It may also due to the heredity, etc. Some main cause of bad postures are accident. Due to accident, there will be the chance of bad postures. Wrong treatment, if the treatment is wrong. Improper treatment, disease, if the person is affected from any health problems, it leads to bad postures. Lack of nutritional diet, if the child does not take proper diet, then there will be the chance of bad postures. Wrong posture habit, if the child has wrong posture habit, was standing, walking, running, then also there will be the chance of bad postures. Psychological stress, if the child is not psychologically fit, if the child take stress, tension, then there will be the chance of bad postures. Lack of strength, if the child has less strength, if he has weak muscles, strength, then his posture will be bad. Age factors, as the age increase, the strength of a person reduce, which leads to bad postures. Poor eyesight, bad shoes, if the child wear bad quality of shoes, tight clothes, etc. These are the some cause of bad posture.